In this video, I will be using the Stable Video Infinity model to generate longer videos. The one you are looking at right now is a 20-second video. I will try to extend this and make a 30-second video. I think the same can be achieved on a smaller 8GB card as well, with the GGUF models. Let's look at the workflow and the files required to make this work. This Torch compile may not work with Sage Attention. I select SDPA when I use Torch compile to speed up the generation process. However, Sage Attention is faster. The model I am using here is the WAN 2.1 image to video FP8 model. You can also use the GGUF model by downloading one from here and then place the file in the UNet folder. The model size is between 8 and 18 gigabyte in size. This 480 pixel model works fine, but if you are looking for quality, then you need to look at the 720 pixel model. The model size for both resolutions are the same, but this one can produce 720 pixel videos. The disadvantage here is the generation time, which depends on the speed and the memory size of the graphics card. This is the 480 pixel FP8 model, the same I am using right now, and below is the 720p version of the same model. My 4060 Ti 16GB has the memory, but generating 720 pixels for a video requires speed as well. Next is the text encoder and the VAE, which we use commonly in all the WAN video workflows. Above is the Lite X2 VLoRa, and this allows generating video with 4 steps. I will provide all the links to these files later. The second LoRa is something we do not use commonly. This SafeTensor file, named as SVI, which stands for Stable Video Infinity, is a model used as a LoRa. This model is responsible for consistency and long video generation. This is the Stable Video Infinity project. I will share the link if you want to get the details on this project. For now, I will go straight for the model files, and these are the models: Dance Talk, Tom and Jerry, and the film model. I have been using the film model. I did download all the models, but haven't tried yet. Back to the workflow, these are the nodes to generate a 5-second video. And here is the prompt given for the video. The reference image is given on the left here, and the result generated is on the right, which is a 16 FPS video. The number of steps you can see here is 8. When using the Lite X2 VLoRa, you can keep the generation steps at 4. But keeping 8 makes the result better. So you can see that the frames are combined after the VAE decodes, and the same frames are going forward in the workflow. So with a reference to the previous 5-second video and a new prompt, the next 5 seconds of the video is generated. On the right, you can see the 16 FPS video generated based on the prompt. Above, after the VAE decodes, the frames again goes further to the next node group. In the third group, the same process is repeated with a prompt that continues on the scene created. The result is the third batch of 81 frames, and all 3 batches of 81 frames goes ahead in the workflow. The same process is repeated again with a different prompt, and then all 4 batches of 81 frames are combined to form a single video. I tried a few attempts, and I found that the consistency remains good in a 20-second video, but when I try to go further, it becomes tough to maintain the character and the scene. I will add 2 more groups in between. Now I just need to have these 2 nodes connected. These are the prompts I will be using to continue the video. The seed ID used here will be different from the previous IDs. It continues from the first group, and then it adds 1 to it. I queued the workflow, and then it took 425 seconds for 8-step video generation. And this is the result. Around 28 seconds, the scene changed completely. In such a case, I can make slight changes in the prompt of the last group. Links to the file required are added in the workflow. And this is the YouTube video. And below are the GGUF models. Links to the both 720p and 480p models are given. Next is the FP8 model. And this is the direct download link to the one I am using right now. This is the link to the Stable Video Infinity model. This is the direct download link to the file I am using right now. Save it inside the LoRa folder. Next is the LightX 2V LoRa. You can get it from here. Or download the one I was using. These are the two text encoders, and I am using the smaller one. The last file is the VAE. To generate video with this workflow, bypass all the groups and generate the first 81 frames. Then proceed further to generate the next 81 frames. The image uploaded is on the left, the prompt is on the right, and the first 81 frames looks good. In the second batch of 81 frames, there is a sudden change in background. I will try this again. A change in the seed ID by adding a number or a slight change in the prompt should fix this. I tried by making changes to the prompt, and now the result looks fine. In the third batch, the man speaks about the mountain and the dormant volcano rumbling deep beneath it. Realizing it's not a safe place to stay, he takes a short break, drinks some water, and continues his journey forward. He begins his descent, ready to leave the mountains behind and head back home. But fate had other plans. A blazing meteor tears through the sky and crashes nearby, changing everything in an instant. So this was the 30-second video generated. The prompt, workflow, and image will be shared on Discord. I also tried the quantized version, the Q6 GGUF model. The GGUF works. Make sure you turn the LoRa merge option as false. This video was generated using the 480p FP8 model. And these are the 6 prompts used to generate the video. And this 30-second video was generated using the Q6 GGUF model. The prompt used is given below. So, this is the low-resolution 30-second video at 16fps. And this is the upscaled 16fps video using this upscale model. The download link for the upscale model will be given in the workflow. This is the 32fps upscale video for quality and smoothness. I kept the video simple and easy to understand, and that is it in this video. I hope you have an excellent day.